Okay, so this video is going to cover simplifying by using the power rules. So if we remember, we have three different power rules. So power rule one says that when we have an exponent raised to another exponent, that we take those exponents and multiply them together. So keep the base, multiply the exponents. Power rule two states that when we have multiple factors inside the parentheses, that exponent that goes around the parentheses goes to everything inside the parentheses. And power rule three states that when we have a fraction being raised to an exponent, that exponent goes to both the numerator and the denominator. So a lot of times when we're using the power rule, it's good to review all three of them because we may see one, two, even all three rules used in the same problem. So let's take a look at what we have going on in this problem here. We have negative 5x cubed, y cubed, all raised to the second power. So typically, when it comes to the power rules, you start down and work your way up. What I mean by that is typically, if you had power rule three, you would start with that, and then power rule two, then power rule one. Now, we don't have a fraction in this problem, so power rule three does not apply. But power rule two does, because here we have an example where we have multiple factors inside our parentheses, and they're all being raised to the second power. So, what that means is that exponent goes to every factor on the inside our parentheses. So that squared goes to the negative 5, that squared goes to the x cubed, and the squared goes to the y cubed. So let's go ahead and show that. So we have a negative 5 that's now being squared. We have x cubed that is also being squared. And we have y cubed, which is also being squared. So now we have this situation here where we can see here we now have cases of power rule one because we have our exponent being raised to another exponent. So let's further simplify. So here in the front we have negative 5 squared. Well, negative 5 times negative 5 is a positive 25. Otherwise, x cubed squared, so keep the x, multiply those exponents, so 3 times 2 gives us a 6. And drop down the y, and once again, 3 times 2 gives us a 6. So our simplified answer would be 25x to the sixth, y to the sixth.